top housing trends to watch for, and how is Michigan's housing market doing? Hello and thanks for joining us. I'm Laurel Hass, and this is Comcast Newsmakers. Joining me now is the Vice President and Regional Director for REMAX of Southeastern Michigan, Joe Sabatini. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So just looking around, it's spring, so folks are thinking about, oh, getting out of the winter blues, and maybe we're going to sell a house, or maybe we're going to buy a house, and the builders are getting going again. Is now a good time to reevaluate and see where exactly the housing market stands?
It is. It's a great time. As you said, it's spring. People are thinking, you know, should we put our house in the market? And it's a prime market right now. So it's definitely a seller's market, and it's a great opportunity for sellers to look at, you know, where they're at and the opportunity for them to move up, or if they're a first-time home buyer, the opportunity to get into their first house.
Why is it so good for sellers right now? I mean, obviously, prices are kind of on the uptick, and they have been for a while, but what is causing that trend?
Well, it's inventory, no question about it. You know, we are, with the seller's market, there is a limited amount of inventory, which makes it difficult for an individual or family to get a property because there's a lot of competition out there. So if you are in the market and you're looking to buy a home, be prepared right now to be in a scenario where you're going to have multiple offers, and be very competitive with your offer that you're making.
Don't come in and tell your agent you want to get a good deal and we want to wait and we want to look. If you want something, you need to jump on it and come in full price, right?
Absolutely. That or higher than full price. You know, that's just the market that we're in. And you know, when the market was different years ago, it was a different scenario. But today, with the seller's market and the limited amount of inventory, you really have to be aggressive.
And interest rates, we've heard so much about they are never going to be this low, they're never going to be this low, but they've been this low, and they're staying this low, at least right now. They're still as low as they've always been.
Yeah, they're still at historical low rates. So I mean, it's a great opportunity for you to get into a property, have a great payment, and you know, when you're looking at rates, and there's always been that suspicion that rates are going to go up, and they're going to go up very quickly, but they've been going up very modestly, and everyone knew that they would be going up, and we're in that position now. So take advantage of a low rate while you have the opportunity.
What about new construction? What effect is that having on the inventory that's out there? I don't know. I have certainly no scientific analysis, but it just seems to me visually there are a lot more new neighborhoods, new construction going up right now.
There are. Builders are making investments again. Years ago, they had to walk away from properties. Now they've gone back in, they're developing again. And they're taking advantage of the opportunities that they have because they know with the market and the limited amount of inventory, they can't build them as fast as they possibly need to right now. So they're really taking you know, the pedal to the metal and trying to take advantage of the market as well.
So you're looking to sell your house right now. What's the best advice you would give someone?
You know, have it in prime condition, ready to sell. Be prepared for multiple people entering the property, and be prepared for multiple offers. So it's an aggressive market. You got to be prepared. Get a great agent that's going to represent you and know what's happening in the market and how to take advantage of your property.
And then on the flip side, you want to purchase. You know you're going to have to act quickly, and you're going to be paying prime dollar. But how do you get a good deal if there are any out there? And how do you make good decisions?
Talk to your lender. You know, that's the first step. See what types of mortgages are available for you. If you're in a cash buying situation, that's even more attractive to a seller, obviously. Limit your terms and be aggressive with your offer because you have to realize that there is competition out there.
Are there some price ranges that are more difficult to find inventory in than others, or some price ranges that, gosh, you can get a really good deal in, different from, you know, other price ranges that might be out there?
You know, every market's different, so that's a tough question to ask. I think when you get into the higher end properties with lending and things that have changed in that scenario, those could be a little bit more challenging with money down and certain jumbo loan rates and how that market has changed as far as on the lending side, so that could be a little bit more challenging today.
All right, well, moral of the story is it's a good time to buy and sell. Know what you're doing when you do, and don't be blindsided, especially if you're selling a house by getting a whole lot of offers. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Pleasure to be here. Thanks so much.
Today's Comcast Newsmaker was Joe Sabatini, the Vice President and Regional Director for REMAX of Southeastern Michigan.